from the six. Look at what we did. Yeah, be quiet, I'm doing a toast. For niggas that don't really do shit, I swear y'all be doing the most. Stop worrying about whoever's next. I am just worried about my mama worrying less. I think I'm famous enough, I don't need any more press. I am convinced I'm the only one left that's still doing this shit, man.
Yes, sir. It's your boy Famous Enough, and I am the voice of the Pro-Am. Now, I don't understand why 2K made it so hard to get boost this year. This is extremely hard. And seeing the first message that you get from your agent, you're gonna automatically pass up the Main Street News one every single time because it's only 10 VC. You're gonna see 100 VC, you're gonna see 10 VC. You're gonna automatically pass up 10 VC every single time. And everybody did this out the gate. And that's why at the end of this video, I'm gonna show y'all how to still go get boost on that first player you made that you passed up that Main Street News endorsement on. Now, I was the same way. On my first player, which was my lockdown, I passed up that endorsement easily. I saw 10 VC. I didn't even read what it said. I just saw the VC symbol next to 10 and the VC symbol next to 150, and I automatically picked that 150 because I didn't know. Nobody told us anything about this when we were going into this. We went in blind, basically. Everybody went in blind. We had no idea what to do or how to get boost or anything like that until somebody said you needed to wear that extra shirt. And we're like, what? What extra shirt? Like, literally, the whole community is like, what are they talking about? What shirt are y'all talking about? Where did you get that shirt from? Nobody knew. It was really to the point, I was really to the point where I was like, you know what? I don't even care about boost no more. I don't care about boost this year. I was set on just playing on that lockdown entire year. And I was like, you know, if I don't get it back, if I don't get that endorsement back, I don't care. Because I'm not even going to fool with it. I'm not going to try to go make a new player and try to get this endorsement because I felt like it just didn't matter. It didn't matter. And it was tough. And then I saw people playing with boosts and I'm like, man, I really might need that boost. Because, you know, on them lockdowns, you're shooting, your three is like a 49. You're like, I really might need that boost. And it was just no way how to get that boost back. And that's where 2K messed up because we had no idea. I guess they didn't mess up because a lot of people went and made new players just to get that endorsement again. Well, get that endorsement offered to them again just so they can go back and get the boost. I just don't understand why 2K hid a lot of stuff from us. We had so much hidden from us. And then it's like, you know what? Maybe it makes sense. Maybe it could be a money grab thing. You know, you never know what the way these companies are. But there's still a way you can get the boost. You just really have to pay attention to what your agent is saying in these texts. A lot of times when I'm playing, now I don't even answer my phone while I'm playing. I'm just going to play my career, go to the training facility, go run Pro-Am, go back to training. You know, that's my whole routine, and the phone is just buzzing. I hardly ever answer it. A lot of times when I do answer it, it's like 3, 4, 5 messages from this guy, from Brian, that I've missed. And that's crazy. It's just that a lot of stuff was hidden from us. Usually you'd be able to buy boost just off the rip just because it's boost. You can just buy it because you want it. But now you got to have that endorsement for it. And it's like, why do I need an endorsement just to buy boost? And like I said from the beginning, so many people are going to pass up that 10 VC and go straight for the 150 just because it's a little bit more, not knowing that how crucial that 10 VC endorsement is. You need that boost. But my dog Mike Wayne, he came through in the clutch. Right here, somebody asked him about the boost. And Mike Wayne said specifically, you can pick it for the first three local endorsements. Weaver's Traffic School, NBA Store, Alley Oop's Tattoo Parlor. And, you know, that's one of those things where we try to skip those local ones and we try to go straight up to the big guys because we're not aware that this is what the local endorsements do. We're not aware of that. Then he go on to say that if you don't pick it either of these three opportunities, it'll be offered as a standalone that you can't skip. The crazy thing about this is nobody has reached that point where it's at a standalone that you can't skip. Everybody has, people have went through a whole season and still hadn't got it without this information before. And my whole thing is about this is, why don't they tell us this from the jump? Why are they telling us midway through the game? Why can't they tell us this from the beginning? If you want boost, make sure you pick a local endorsement to start your career. Why don't we get that information? This is one of those things that boggles me about 2K. The same thing that happened with the dribble moves and the rating, the 86 and the 90 that C Hoops posted. You know, we didn't know about that at all. And we didn't know that you needed an 86 or a 90. We didn't know what archetypes had an 86 or 90 until C Hoops told us. And see, then we had the whole the whole dunking thing that we had no clue about until C Hoops told us. That's the type of things that 2K need to realize when they're putting these games together, that they have to include this stuff in the information that we need. We need this information. We are, at the beginning of the game, we couldn't see what rating we were moving up. We couldn't see it. So we were in blind, and we didn't know if certain archetypes had those dribbles and all that. We didn't know. So 2K needs to tell us this from the jump. We can't go in blind. That's one thing that we can't do as players that's heading into such a big year for 2K. Now, as you see, I'm at Main Street News right now. I got my extra shirt on. I just talked to the clerk once. I'm going to go back in and talk to him again just so I can get the boost to pop up. Now, if we had this information from the beginning, people probably wouldn't have made 2 and 3 players if they knew about the boost from the beginning and how to get it. But since players didn't know how to get boosts from the beginning, we were stuck. We were stuck, and we had to make a choice. Make a new player because we don't have boosts, or just go without boosts. So some people actually did make new players because they didn't have boosts. That is a big thing. That is a huge thing that 2K needs to address with giving us information about certain things of this magnitude. This is stuff we need to know off rip. You know, this is stuff that we really need to know. So, if you want boost, always select a local endorsement to get the boost, to get the Main Street News shirt, whatever, the extra. That's the bottom line, man. That's the bottom line. If you're feeling the content, like, comment, and subscribe. And as always, if you know me, but I don't know you, then I guess I'm famous enough.